Hello friends, today we are going to discuss about Azure API management. In this session, we will understand how to create API management, host our first API on API management. We will also understand what is policies, what is the use of that, what is subscription key in API management, what is the product and how we can use the developer portal. Apart from that, we will also understand what are the available monitoring tools in API management. Then we will understand the deployment and infrastructure configuration in API management. And finally, we will understand the security part of API management. So let's start. API management, in short APIM, is a way to create consistent and modern API gateways for existing backend services. So API management helps organization publish API to external partner and internal developers to unlock the potential of their data and services. So API management provides the core competency to ensure a successful API program through developer engagement, business insight, analytics, security. We can use Azure API management to take any backend and launch a full-fledged API program based on it. So let's understand how we can create the API management. Let's go to the Azure portal, and here either we can choose Azure API management from here, or we can search here in API management. So click on this icon, API management, and then click on the create. Once you click on create, choose the subscription, choose the resource group, and choose the region accordingly. So here, in resource name, I'll provide my resource name. API, APIMRG, okay, so let's select the resource name. Now let's give the organization name myapim.org. Okay, administrator email here. Now in pricing tier, let's see what we have in the pricing tier. So if you can see, we have different pricing tiers available here in developer, basic, standard, premium, isolated, and consumption. So we will use here a developer, because and it will charge for $0.07 per hour. Okay, so this one we can use for the non-production environment. So let's choose the developer edition. So in pricing tier we have different options. So we will choose developer edition. We will not have any SLA here. If we'll go to the basic, we will get the 99.95% SLA. Again, for standard, premium, and consumption, we have a different SLAs. So let's choose the developer. We want to understand the complete pricing tier. You can visit this URL. Let's move to the monitoring part. Now, if you want to enable the application insight, you can just click on and choose your application insight instance. As of now, I have not created any application insight instance, so it is coming not available. So let's make it off, go to the next scale. So for developer and consumption tier, it will not support it. Okay, so scale units are not supported in developer and consumption tier. Let's go back to the basic and let's try to choose the different one. So I'll try to select the basic, and now I'll go to the scale. You can see we have two units, 1 and 2. Let's choose a different pricing tier. If I'll go to the standard, if I'll go to the premium, let's see what are the options we have. So if you can see, we have 10 units available when we go to the premium pricing tier. But again, if you'll go to the premium pricing tier, we have to pay accordingly. So premium pricing tier is 3.83 per hour. Okay, and there are different features also, there are different purposes also available here for the pricing tier. So price, so premium one will be like high volume or enterprise production use cases. You can use the pricing tier, premium pricing tier. Okay, so let's go and select the developer. We'll go to scale. Will not, it is not supported, so we will not get any option. We'll move to the next, manage identity. Again here we will make it off. If you want to enable it, you just have to click on you have to just select on. So as of now we will choose the by default. Let's go to the virtual network. So here by default it will be none. If you want to provide the access for external or internal, accordingly you can choose. As of now, for this demo purpose, we will choose none. Move to the protocol setting. So see, we have a different settings here. So suppose if you can see here, we have TLS 1.2, TLS 1.0 and TLS 3.0. Okay, so these are off, and these are the client side transport security, client side protocol and cipher information. Let's move to the next tag. Will not change anything here. Move to the next. These are the tags where we can provide the name and the value of that. Click on next, review and create. So it will validate. It will do the final validation check. So you can see validation passed. Okay, so here you can just check all the information, whatever configuration you have done, you can verify it here. Okay, once you click on create, it will start creating, it will start the deployment, or it will start creating the resources of the API management. It will take around 40 to 50 minutes to create the Azure API management. So what I mean, I have already created my Azure API management here. So for this demo purpose, we will go through that. Okay, so for now, I'll just close this. So when we open the Azure APIM, it will come, it will be visual like this. Okay, so here we'll have all the information. Now let's create our first API in APIM. So for that, we just have to click on this left panel, APIs, click on that. Okay, so when you go here, we can see a different options. We can create a blank API. We can create from definition, VSDL or WDL. Okay, or we can create from Azure's resources also, like from Logic App, from App Services or Function App. Okay, so for this demo purpose, we will use Function App. So let's go to the Function App. All right, so here we can choose our Function App. So let's click on Function App. So if you can see, we have not created any Function App yet, that's why nothing is coming here. So for that, we will just go and search our Function App. Okay, so I'll create a very simple Function App here. So I'll just click on create. I'll go to the resource. Okay, so my fun, I'll choose the code .NET. Reason, I'll choose best US because my API is also located in the same region. Okay, and in hosting, I'll choose consumption plan, review and create. It will not take much time. So now you can see Function App has been created. We'll go to the resources. Okay, and we'll create one function here. So I'll click on function, click on add, and here I'll choose HTTP trigger, and we'll provide the function name HTTP trigger. Okay, I'll not change anything here. In authorization level, I'll select anonymous. For this demo purpose, I am choosing this anonymous, but do not choose anonymous production environment. So now you can see my function is created. Let's click on that function. We'll go to code and test. So now we will test our function. So for that we will just hit on test and run. Okay, so here if you can see, we have two methods, get and post. Okay, so we will choose post and hit on run. Okay, we got the 200 success response and we have received also the response hello Azure, this HTTP trigger function executed successfully. Fine, so that means my function is running fine. Now again I'll go back to the my APIM. I'll click on APIs, select function app, and here click on browse. Now click on the function app and see, you have now your function app available here. Just select that function app, click on select, it will load the trigger. So HTTP trigger has been loaded. Now we'll select that. So your function app name is available. Display name, if you want to change, you can change your display name, and this will be the base URL. Click on create button, it's done. Okay, so we have successfully created our first API on API management. Okay, so now if you can see, we have two operations here, get and post, for this function that we have just imported. So we have this get and post. Okay, so now let's test that. Okay, so as we saw, this function is working fine here. So let's see if this function is working on APIM as well. Okay, so how we can do that? So we'll select our get or post, any operation. So let's select the post operation and then select the test. Okay, so now here let's click on send, and we got 200 success response. That means it's working fine without any issue. All right, let's test it on some different way also. Okay, so we have here APIM developer portal. Okay, so we'll go to the portal overview. First we will publish that. Okay, so if you can see, your developer portal has not been published yet. Okay, so first we have to publish it. So let's click on publish. Yes. Okay, and we'll select this deprecated developer portal. So just click on that. In the later session I'll explain you how we can use this developer portal, what is the use of this developer portal, APIM developer portal. Okay, now let's go to the API and select the API that we have created, myfun, and we can choose any operation like post or get. So we'll choose post and hit on try. Okay, now we will just send the message and we'll see. All right, so if you can see here, we are getting 401 access denied, and the error message is saying due to missing subscription key we are getting this access denied. Though this API was working on here on APIM gateway, and the same is working on our function app. So this function app is running fine, this is working fine. If you want, let's hit again run. If you'll see, this is working fine. If I'll go to the my APIM, if I'll click on post method, go to the test, and here also if you just pass send, we are getting 200. But when we are sending the message here, we are getting 401 access denied. Okay, it is saying missing subscription key. So let's see what is the difference between APIM developer portal and the APIM. So I'll go to the APIM, and here in HTTP request, if you can see, so here we are passing the Azure subscription key. Okay, but in developer portal we are not passing. In header, if you can see, we are just passing OCP APIM traces, but we are not passing the subscription key. But here we are passing subscription key and the traces. Okay, so let's try to pass this subscription key here, and we'll see if it resolve our issue or not. Okay, so I'll explain you why, from where you can get this one, and why this is needed. okay, and what is what is if we have any alternate solution for that. Okay, so I have just added the header. I'll click on send. Perfect. So we got 200 success response. Okay, so we have added this header and then it's working fine. Let's remove this header and hit again send. We are again getting the same error. Okay, so what is the alternate approach? If we don't want to pass the subscription key, how we can test that, how we can send the message. Okay, so for that, what you can do, you just have to go to the settings, and in the setting, if you scroll down, you can see this subscription required. Okay, so just uncheck this box and click on save. For this demo purpose, I am doing that, but this is not recommended. Okay, so for just demo purpose, I just uncheck this subscription required and we'll test it. We'll go to the test, we'll select the operation here and let's test it. It is working fine. Okay, let's test this one also. It is working fine. Perfect. So if you can see, now it is working fine on API management and even API developer portal as well. Let's go back and refer the changes in settings. So let's check box, click on save, and we can just double confirm. It should not work. Yeah, so we are getting 401 access denied. All right. Okay, so now let's understand from where this value is coming. Okay, from which place this value is coming, the subscription key. Okay, so to understand, let's just see what are the key we have it. So the subscription key, it is started with 638524. Okay, so here in the APIs tab, if you can see, we have this subscription. So just click on that subscription, and here if you can see, we have three subscription available here. Okay, so one is under product started scope, another is products unlimited scope, and another is services. Okay, so let's try to see the keys. Okay, so if we can see, this is the same key, this is the same subscription key that we have used in our request, and after that it was successfully processed. Okay, so from here you can get the subscription information or subscription key. All right. Okay, so in the later session we will discuss more about this subscription key, what is the use of this subscription key. Okay, how we can use that, how we can use this subscription key in our developer portal as well. That's it for the today's session. In this session, we have understand what is API management, how we can create our API management, and we have also hosted our first API on API management. Next session, we will understand policies, what is policies in API management, and what is the use of that policy, how we can configure that policy, and also we will understand some different topics like what is the subscription, what is the product, how we can configure the developer portal, what is the use of developer portal in API management, and remaining topics we will understand in the later video. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed watching this video and learned what is API and how to use the API management. If you have any query or any suggestion, please feel free to contact me. If you like this video, please hit the like button and share it with your friends and others. Have a great day.